Space is a mysterious place. And you know what happens to mysterious things in life? There's a lot of misconceptions around them. Sometimes TV, movies, your friends, or even your own senses can lie to you when it comes to the truth about space. In the next few minutes, your universe is gonna turn upside down. My name is Danny Burke, and this is the top 10 lies you were told about space. Coming in at number 10, black holes are holes. Seems obvious, doesn't it? What is a black hole? It's a hole. You get pulled in one side of the big black circle and sucked into oblivion. That's the way sci-fi movies and TV shows and even some documentaries like to show it, but it's not true. Black holes are technically spheres, the 3D version of a circle. An object could get pulled in on any side, not just one or two. If that has made black holes a lot scarier for you, then I'm sorry. I don't really know how to sugarcoat black holes. They're quite dangerous. At number 9 now, the sun is on fire. It looks like it, doesn't it? Movies, cartoons, and even our own eyes make it look like the sun is burning in the same way a piece of wood would burn, but it's not. What's really going on is nuclear fusion. That happens at its core, which is hidden from view. The result, though, is a lot of heat and a lot of gamma rays. The gamma rays then get converted into visible radiant light. Yes, I'm very fun at parties. At number 8 now, we only have one moon. I'm gonna get very technical here, annoyingly technical. We only have one permanent moon, it's called the moon. But we often have other temporary moons that orbit Earth. They're very small and they don't last forever. Scientists have found that at least one small asteroid is orbiting Earth at any given moment. There may be many more, but they're too small to track. In 2006, astronomers tracked one of these mini moons. It was about the size of a car. They usually only orbit for about 9 months before being pulled towards the sun, but some of them stay for decades. At number 7 now, Mercury is the hottest planet. Seems like an obvious one, doesn't it? The outer planets have insanely low temperatures, and the ones that are closer to the sun are a lot hotter. Mercury is the closest, so it must be the hottest. Not true though. Can any of you guys tell me which planet is the hottest? Well done if you said Venus. The thick atmosphere of carbon dioxide on Venus means that the temperature sits at around 462 degrees Celsius for most of the years, about 40 degrees hotter than Mercury ever gets. One thing they both have in common though is instant death if we got teleported there. Nice. At number 6 now, we have no gravity in space. There is gravity in almost every bit of space. It's what keeps the moon orbiting us and the sun in its position in the galaxy. What astronauts are experiencing when they orbit the Earth is actually microgravity. A spacecraft above Earth is always falling towards it. However, if it goes fast enough and at the right angle, it will always miss it and keep going round and round and round. That's how it orbits. Astronauts in that craft will experience exactly the same thing as someone in a falling elevator or a theme park ride that drops, the illusion of weightlessness. The difference is, it doesn't end for astronauts until they come back down. Alright, moving on to number 5 now. We have sound in space. A lot of people watch Star Wars or Star Trek or Guardians of the Galaxy. They see the cool space battles and they think, there must be sound in space. Well, I'm afraid Hollywood has been lying to you. There is no sound in space, or to be more technical, you can't hear what's happening outside of your bubble. So if you're in a spacecraft, you can hear something hitting the spacecraft because the impact will vibrate the air molecules inside the craft. If you're watching from outside of the spacecraft though, there's the vacuum of space in between with no molecules to vibrate. So no sound. At number 4 now, you can see the Great Wall of China from space. This myth has been around for so long, but it's just not really true. There was a picture taken from the International Space Station in 2004 that kind of showed the wall, but it was taken with a camera, with a zoom lens. Every astronaut has said that it just can't be seen with the naked eye. It's just too similar in color to the surrounding area. There's also the myth that you can see the wall from the moon. Let's not even go there. Coming in at number 3 now, the sun is yellow. Now with this one, I don't really blame them for telling us that the sun is yellow because our eyes agree with it. It does look yellow, but it's not. The sun is actually white in color. The reason it appears yellow is because of how the light is bent in our atmosphere, called Rayleigh scattering. It's also the reason the sky appears blue and sunsets look orange and red. So, next time you guys think the sun looks extra beautiful, give our atmosphere some credit in the comments below. What? Hashtag atmosphere. Moving on to number 2 now. The Russians used a pencil. I'm sure some of you guys have heard the story about how in the 1960s, NASA spent millions of dollars developing a pen that would work in the microgravity of space. Meanwhile, the Russians used a pencil. It's a funny story, but it's just not true. In 1965, NASA bought a whole bunch of pencils for their astronauts to use. Later on, a company did develop a pen that would work in space, and both NASA and the Russians started to use it. Trust me, I don't feel good about ruining a great story like this, but you know I'm all about truth in this video. And finally at number 1, people explode in space. Here's a nice gory one to end on. A lot of people seem to have picked up on the idea that if you were to take off your spacesuit in space, the insanely low pressure would just pop you. You would just explode like a big bag of flesh and guts. Lovely. The truth is though, our skin is tough. If we were in space with no protection, you would bloat as the liquids and gases in you try to escape, but it wouldn't be enough to burst your organs or your skin. So don't worry, it would actually be the dissolved gases in your blood forming bubbles that would kill you. So that's a nice silver lining. Alright guys, if any of you know me by now, you know I could talk about space until everyone dies of boredom. I won't go that far, but I will do a part 2 of this if you want me to. Let me know. My name is Danny Burke, and I will see you all in the next video.